Hello guys, in this video I'm going to do some work on these two Lenovo T440 laptops. Okay, so first of all, both of them came without chargers, so I needed to buy chargers. This one isn't in the best of shapes, but it's still able to do the job. I wish I would have noticed this when I actually bought it second hand, obviously, because I prefer to buy original second hand instead of aftermarket new. Don't really like aftermarket chargers. This one is in way better shape. It was a bit more expensive, I think, and it didn't come with this charger cable, sorry. So I needed to buy one separately, but that one is still usable. Okay, let me show you the specs for these things. Windows 7 Pro license will be upgraded to Windows 10 as I always do. It's an i5-4300U. It does have a BIOS password, so hopefully it still allows us to boot from the hard drive, because if it doesn't, we might have a few issues, as it's extremely hard to reset the BIOS password on this T440s, and I don't think you can actually do it for free, and I'm not too keen on paying for resetting a password. Hopefully it doesn't affect us. And yeah, no hard drive, so we'll be putting this 500 gigs SATA one in. Should be all okay. And another thing, the guys that I buy from use scotch tape to glue this onto computers. And yes, it took off the layer, the rubberized layer on top of this laptop. Yeah, annoying. Really, 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 really annoying. But nothing else that I can do now. Absolutely nothing else that I can do now. If I could actually take it all off, but it's not going to come off. No, for sure it's not going to come off. So this reduces the value of this laptop rather dramatically. So I'm going to try and contact them and explain that they should try to use any other sort of adhesive tape that doesn't glue this well. So yeah, what can you do? Bad stuff happens. Just so that on the other side we have some, or actually no, this is only glue residue, so it only messed it up here. I will see, maybe I use something to brush the whole surface of this thing and get rid of that layer. I don't know, but I always hated rubberized paint, so what can I say? And this other one, about the same configuration. It already has a 500 gigs hard drive in it, also BIOS password, but it also has a broken hinge, as you can see. So yeah, I think I'm going to deal with this one first and make room, because this one probably needs to be opened up. So let's get to it. Okay, didn't plug in the charger yet. Let's try and see if it has some battery left. Nah, not lucky. I was really curious to see what that BIOS password actually affects. It seems we cannot see that until we plug in the charger. Okay, let's see. Okay, to interrupt normal startup, press enter. Not going to press enter, or am I going to press enter? are we waiting for? Choose temporary boot device. Yeah, so I can choose what I boot from. That doesn't affect me at all. And I think, yeah, it doesn't see a hard drive, so it doesn't have anything to boot from. Yeah, I think we're good. I think the BIOS password on this thing doesn't affect anything interesting. Let's try to enter the BIOS, and probably here we will get the prompt for the password. Yeah. So it is asking us for a password. But don't care about that at all. The fact that we can boot from whatever we need is enough in my book. I made a separate video where I fully removed the rubber coating on that laptop, so it is just bare plastic at this moment. You can even see the zones where the injection of molten plastic took place on the other side. But honestly, it looks interesting, and it's way better than just having that rubber fall off in various places. On this one, I do not know at the moment if I will remove it, because it also has that problem. So yeah, remains to be seen. So let's put the hard drive in that one at this time. As you can see, the caddy is missing, but that should be no problem to us. And I think it should have one of these, maybe in this other side, or no, probably it was just for grounding. But because we don't have the caddy anymore, I want to balance it a little bit. And obviously I have turned down enough stuff, so I would have something like this to put on the other side with zero issues whatsoever. Okay, so let's see. And next we would actually require some double-sided tape, I'm thinking. Yep, that should be it. So let's get some. Okay, hard drive is in. I made a separate video which will hopefully be linked in the description. If I forget, please ask for it, showing you how to loosen up the hinges so we do not end up breaking the case like on this one, because Lenovo's, from what I've encountered, are particularly problematic with too tight of a hinges in time, so they end up either breaking the hinge itself or breaking the case. In this one we have solved this problem, so this one will never break the case like this one did. This one a bit too late, but I will still manage to fix it somehow. So let's boot from this USB drive, plug it in. Hopefully we do have a bit of a charge, or actually nope, we don't have a bit of a charge. I thought that it had a chance to charge a little bit, but what actually didn't it? No, it didn't. So I left it way too little plugged in to get a charge. So, where is F12? Just remember, if you ever have problems with a laptop that also has an integrated battery, there is a way to reset it without opening it up. Remove the external battery and you should have a hole somewhere. And a little switch, you can, maybe you cannot hear it, but I feel the action. Perfect. Okay, I've held it for a few seconds. Now everything should be reset. And I have no clue. It doesn't seem to be liking my my standard drive, but it boots from the Windows 8 one. I don't really know what it doesn't like. This is a bit weird actually. Maybe I've somehow messed up my drive and it's not bootable anymore. I need to say that wouldn't be the first time. This is really, really, really weird. I don't know why it's taking so long. I think I'm going to actually open it up and also remove the internal battery and disconnect the BIOS battery for a second so this thing gets a fresh start. I always hate password protected BIOSes. They can cause trouble, and maybe this is somehow related to that, or my USB drive just doesn't like it that much. Okay, so this thing just does not want to boot from my USB drive, which is rather annoying. I have no clue if I messed it up somehow, and I don't think I have another USB drive available to test this. Yeah. Maybe it doesn't like the fact that it's actually USB 3.0. This is USB 2.0. But this should convert it. The other problem is that I have YAMI on this thing. Meaning that it's not... it's Linux, not Windows, not MS-DOS or whatever at the deepest level. It's a Linux thing, so... Maybe it's somehow set up in the BIOS not to accept that, or maybe legacy mode is disabled, or it accepts only UEFI. It's set to UEFI booting, so that is why it doesn't take this, because this doesn't know UEFI, the Linux thing on this USB drive. I could remove the hard drive and put Windows on it on another laptop, but that would be a bit annoying. I don't know, I will be back in a moment. I'm going to think about it and see what I do. I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to use this 160 gigabytes empty hard drive from another laptop. I need to take out the case on it, whatever. That laptop is not working anymore and I don't think I can fix it, and use it as a USB thumb drive, and put a Windows 10 with Media Creation Tool, a Windows 10 install kit on this thing. So we will be installing Windows 10 from a hard drive, not a USB drive. And if it starts up from this thing, it's clear that it just wants UEFI and nothing else. Okay, before making the bootable hard drive, just remember that I have a 240 gigabytes SSD laying around. It's waiting to be put in a laptop, and yeah, if you go big, why not do it the biggest way you can. So let's try and boot from this thing. It has a Windows 10 on it at the moment, but this is just as a proof of concept, because while I was putting Windows 10 on it, I realized this thing has a Windows 7 license. So I need to put Windows 7 first and upgrade it to Windows 10, so we get a Windows 10 valid license. So I've done a bit of online digging around, and it seems that a new Yummy version for UEFI boot actually exists. So if this starts up the Windows 10 install from this drive, that actually means that it needs to be a UEFI boot device. So I'm going to use that version of Yummy to put a Windows 7 clone on this thing, then activate it and then upgrade it to Windows 10. But yeah, let's wait for it to actually see this thing and try and boot from it. Yeah, so it is in need of a UEFI capable boot device. Which my thumb drive is not capable with the Yummy version that it has on it now. So let's put a newer Yummy version on this thing, because I still don't have a drive big enough to hold what I need for this laptop to work. A bit annoying. Well, now Secure Boot is blocking me to boot into Yummy. So I have the UEFI version, all is okay. Secure Boot doesn't like it, but it says on the Yummy website to disable Secure Boot, but because I cannot enter the BIOS, I cannot disable it. So yeah, companies, when you sell your stuff, please remove the BIOS passwords. Selling your old hardware with BIOS passwords on them is just an irresponsible way of not letting people use them at full potential. Not normal, and in a society where we want to try and be as green as possible and use stuff like this for as long as possible in the future, so we don't create more e-waste, crap like this is just in the way. Okay, so I've put a Windows 7 install kit on this thing, Windows 7 Pro, with Rufus. Rufus is somewhat similar to Yummy, you can put ISOs on drives with it. So this thing is allowing us to boot only above Windows 8. Am I getting this right? Okay, so in the end, again with this thing with Windows 10 on it, and I'm actually installing directly Windows 10, and I will hopefully be able to activate it with the Windows 7 key on this laptop, because Windows 7, I've done a bit of research, does not support Secure Boot. So with the locked BIOS, I am clearly unable to disable Secure Boot, so I cannot install anything below Windows 8. So Windows 10 and hopefully Windows 7 key will work to activate it. If not, I don't know what I will do. Ta-da! Windows 10 is activated and working perfectly. And again, I made a separate video on how to install it and activate it with a Windows 7 in this case, or even 8 key at the end of 2018. So Microsoft still allows you to use older keys to activate Windows 10. They want you to have Windows 10. Almost all drivers installed by themselves, so I will tinker with those just for a bit longer, and it actually requires a restart from me, which is quite good. Everything working really well. Okay, already did most settings the way I like them. And with the hard drive working at what 100% all the time, and the CPU turboing to 2.8, sometimes this battery still says almost 2.5 hours. So under normal load, this thing probably goes 4 hours and more than 4 hours, which is pretty good. In my book, this is decent battery life. Because again, we are installing a lot of stuff, and I am also pounding away at it in the background while doing settings and whatnot. As you can see, our partition exactly 180 gigs, exactly the way I like to make it, even numbers and round numbers, whatever you actually call them. Updates are waiting for a restart. But after all, everything else finishes only, and yeah, we are almost ready with this thing. So the minor inconvenience is the password in the BIOS, which only affects us if we actually want to install something older than Windows 8. I'm thinking that even newer Linux versions should support the feature that prevented us from installing Windows 7 on this thing. Hopefully, not really sure. I'm not that into Linux, actually at all into Linux. Used it just a handful of times. So, Avira installing, and it should be the last thing that needs to be installed. Ta-da! It's finished. And this thing, yeah, not the coolest ever, but still better than having that rubberized paint come off only where it wanted to come off. Hinge is working perfectly now. Like what you see? Yes, I do. Yeah, what can I say? This one finished. Of course, there are use marks, and this particular it's not a coat, actually. I think that actually maybe this is glass, and the glass itself has rugosity. So you actually do polish it with your finger while using it. So maybe it's not the ideal way how Lenovo does it, because in time it will get polished. But also will the keys that get used the most. So yeah. It is what it is. Can't do anything about it. There are, you could actually, if you really want, you could try and make it all, I don't know, scratch it all in the same direction to give it some texture, or even paint it spray can, I don't know. But the best possible thing, it would be just to put how are they called I don't know, the stuff that dbrand sells, for example, to put on the back of your phone. So you simply put a layer, you glue it on top of it and just cut it. It will still work. A colleague of mine has something like that at work. He hated this, so he put a white layer on his touchpad, and it's looking good and working still perfectly. So yeah, that's that. Avira, I think it's still doing some updates because it just closed and it will open itself back up. It does that a few times after you install it the first time. And yeah, that's about it. I just noticed this thing actually even has a webcam on it, which, yeah, useful for some, doesn't matter for others, whatever. Yeah, that's about it. Speakers working, tested them, fingerprint present. I don't use it at least, so yeah. Everything is good, hard drive working perfectly. That's about it for this first part of the video, and then we will start working on the other one for the second part, because this video is really long and it gets two parts in the end. So sorry about that. Yeah, for this part at this moment, bye bye and thank you for watching. In a few days, second part will be uploaded, so stay tuned for that. Bye again.